Welcome back, Rankers. Look what I got in the mail, or dropped on my doorstep yesterday. Just in time for winter coming up and for starting the fire. I'm not being rude, that's what we use it for. Now, look, I know it's easy. A lot of you say, you know, taking a kick at yellow pages. And you're right, it is. So off we go. Right, I'm doing a webinar this week on effective web video marketing. And for quite a while now, I've been following this channel called Yellow Pages Upload. And I first came across it because we found that there were some AdWords campaigns being run by Census and directing them back to pages not dissimilar to this one. And then we had a little embedded video in here. Now, this was uploaded on February the 3rd, this new video. And so far, it's had two views, one of which is mine. What we're going to teach you on Thursday is a little bit about YouTube, how to get your videos found in YouTube, how to increase your video viewership, but also some other hosting options you may want to consider if YouTube is not for you. And there's several reasons why YouTube may not be for you, which we'll also cover on Thursday. But a couple of the things that you always should do with your video, and I don't know, Census may be doing these for free. And that's great for the client, but they're not getting a lot of views on YouTube. And the reason for that is there's not a lot of search information around it. There's not a lot of great metadata to tell you what the video is about. And interestingly, I'm on a playlist now in that all these Yellow Pages uploads seem to be connected to each other. So if you play one, the others will all keep playing. That's one technique to get views on your entire channel. Not one I'd recommend because people would probably press pause pretty quickly or stop the download like I'm about to do. But the things that are missing here are keywords that people look for. So we've got the mobile shredding company here. We don't have anything in the description. That's a big no-no. Need to put something in the description. And of course, no tags, and we've just got it in people and blogs. So it's almost like these maybe have been uploaded here by Yellow Pages just as a extra free service or something like that, because I'm sure they wouldn't, you know, charge to do something like this, because it just seems like they're using it to embed into the Yellow Pages actual page for that particular client. But if I go and search for shredding company, because I'm not going to search for the mobile shredding company, right? And I don't even know whether YouTube is the place that I'd search for that. But you can see here, this one is number one, and they've only got one view. And this one was uploaded, well, it's new, so it's only recent. But if we're going to have a look at the Yellow Pages Upload channel, we can see that there's a lot of videos there with zero views. So they're obviously using it for the landing page on the Yellow Pages online directory. I don't know whether these view numbers here are indicative of the number of times that someone has pressed play, or actually, sorry, someone has actually been to the page and pressed play, because, you know, it's not that prominent, is it? So that's, I guess, one way that some companies are using video. But with all the videos that I've looked at up here, they're the sort of video that you would see as a, I don't know, country television station ad. That, you know, 30-second, 40-second grab that tells you a little bit about the company. You can do a lot more with YouTube than that, and I think that's the mindset of television that we've, you know, had for the last 50 years, that this is an interruptive medium, and we're putting this television ad in front of you, and now we're gone. That's not the way YouTube works. YouTube is the world's second biggest search engine. So if you're going to go to the trouble of putting a video up, get some keywords in there, and try to tell a little bit of a story about why whatever it is that you're doing is unique. And there are so many examples of where this has worked well. You're not restricted to the 40 seconds of television. Now, if you get a new account, you'll be able to put up 15 minutes as a minimum video. Every time you put up a video, put up 15 minutes. Now, that isn't to say you spend 15 minutes talking about your company. I mean, how many times do I talk about what we do here? By the way, we do AdWords, SEO, and web development. But that's not what these videos are about. These videos are about establishing your business, or even you personally, as an authority in what you do and something interesting to find out more about your product. If I was this guy, this CAN security monitoring guy, I'd be setting up a weekly video blog or even a fortnightly video blog about different security systems that you could employ. He's from Cairns, so are there specific things in tropical areas that you need to think about, you need to consider that you don't say in the southern zones? So video is a totally different animal. And remember, YouTube is a search engine. It's the world's second largest, and people search for stuff. So security monitoring, they may or may not search. They may search for security systems or how to install a security system. When you start doing that, you might get views that are absolutely totally worthless to you at that time. You might get them from overseas or whatever. But as your viewership grows, it will appear more in other people's channels because YouTube now has all this different sharing. When I go and when you log in, you can see what other people you subscribe to are doing. So you're sharing this video around and it's getting a lot more views that way and opening you up to new experiences. And if you're the person in Cairns that's talking about security monitoring and you've got a YouTube channel, then you're the guy to go to because you've got the authority. So that's what I'm talking about on Thursday and how to do that easily, cheaply, and get a real payback on your investment of time, because that's all it takes. YouTube is free. It doesn't cost you anything to upload. And, you know, after a while, you will get to the point, if you do your videos regularly enough, become a YouTube partner, which is what I am. I can go and put advertising over all my videos, but I don't do it for a very good reason, and that is because all my competitors' advertising would appear on my videos. But if I wanted to, if I wanted to try to monetize my content, I could. There's one guy who is purportedly making about $1 million a year just by putting up videos that he's remashed and commenting on YouTube. He gets about 5 million views a week, and they are then monetized through the use of advertising over those ads, and he makes about $1 million a year from Google. So there's another number of things that you can do with video. If you want to sit in on the webinar, it's free. And if you go to our newsletter and our website, you will find at the bottom of the blog post that's attached to this video a link to this particular go-to webinar. We're doing it in conjunction with Citrix. Now, it's on 1 o'clock Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time, and that's the, you know, Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane, for those of you who don't know. If you're in the US Eastern time, that means it's about 9 o'clock at night. So maybe you've just popped the kids off to bed and you want to come and watch this video. There's already about 500 people that have registered to watch the video. I don't know what the limit is, and Citrix is probably going to kill me for promoting it more this week. But it's this Thursday. Sorry, 9 o'clock. Not Thursday night, it's 9 o'clock Wednesday night if you're in the US. In Australia, it's 1 o'clock on the Thursday. And that is it for this week's show. We'll see you next week. Thanks very much. Bye.